Dear student, in this lecture we are going to learn about hubs and switches in link layer. So first we know about the importance of hubs and switches. LAN, local area network, does not normally operate in isolation, but they are connected to one another to the internet. Fine. Or internet. So to connect a LAN, connecting devices are needed, and these devices are called hubs, switches, repeaters, routers, bridges, like that. So what is hub? Hub is used as a central point of connection among media segments, and cables from network devices plug in the port on the hub. These are the ports of hub. Fine. So, but hub does not perform any processing on the data it forwards, and it does not check any error. There are two types of hubs here. First one is passive hub and second one is active hub. So passive hub is just a connector. It connects the wire coming from different branches in a star topology, Ethernet, LAN. A passive hub is just a point where the signals coming from different station collides, and the hub is the collision point. So the signal passes through a passive hub without regeneration and amplification, connects several network cables together. Now we are moving on active hubs. So active hubs is regenerator or amplify the signal before they are retransmitted. That means active hub is actually a multi-port repeater. It is normally used to create multiple levels of hierarchy, such as in a physical star topology. So basically hub is used to connect computers directly, and when data packets arrive at hub, it broadcasts them to all the LAN cards in a network, and the destined reception picks them all the and all other computers discard the data packet. Hubs come in a variety of shapes and sizes, as you know. See, these are the pictures of hub. So it having some varieties and shapes, and hub has 5, 8, 16 and more ports, and one port is known as uplink port, which is used to connect with the next hub. Now we are discuss switch. So switch is a device in a computer network that connect other devices together, and multiple data cables are plugged into a switch to enable communication between different network devices. While if we are talking about hub and switches, both are connecting device. So what are the difference between hub and switches? So hub forward the data it received to all of the ports on the device, but switch forward it only to the port that connect to the destination device. So unlikely a hub or switch split the network traffic and send it to different destination rather than to all system on the network. So these are the pictures of switches, and how switches manage the data flow. So switches manage the data flow across a network by transmitting a received network packet only to the one or more devices for which packet is intended, and each networked device connected to a switch can be identified by its network address, allowing the switch to direct the flow of traffic, maximizing and security and efficiency of the network. So in a network, switches use the three methods to transmit the data. First one is store and forward, cut through and fragment free. So first we are discuss cut through. In a cut through switching environment, the packet being to be forwarded as soon as it received, and this method is very fast but create the possibility of errors begin propagate through the network as there is no error checking. Now second one is store and forward. So unlikely cut through, in a store and forward switching environment, the entire packet is received and error checked before being forwarded, and the upside of this method is that error and are not propagated through the network. So the downside in the error Checking process take a relatively long time and store and forward switching is considerable slower as a result. Now we are moving on third one and last one, that is fragment free. So in the fragment free, error checking of a store and forward switching. Fragment free having some advantage of error checking of store and forward switching, but still offer performance level nearing that of cutthroat switching. Fragment free switching can be used in a fragment free switching environment. Enough of the packet is read so that the switch can determine whether the packet has been involved in a collision as soon as collision state has been determined the packet and forwarded. I hope you understand well about switches and hubs. So thank you.